Hello and welcome to another edition of Football Planet here on Africa News. Thanks for choosing this as your reference point for everything football. My name is Juliet Bowa. So ahead in the next few minutes, we'll take you around the continent and beyond, bringing you up to speed with who is winning what and who is fighting a relegation battle. Stay with us here on Football Planet. We begin with our quote of the week, and this week is dedicated to an amazing player on and off the field. Ivory Coast Didier Drogba continues to inspire a generation of African football greats. Right, so most of Europe's popular football leagues have successfully come to an end with major winners declared. From Italy through to England, there was plenty of football action and Africa's biggest legs were in action all seasons. Here are some slides that should interest you. Right, so one player who had an exciting season was Watford's Jude Ighalo. From scoring week in and week out, he became a hot commodity in top-flight English football. He joins us via Skype to talk about his exploit. Ighalo, thanks for joining us here on Football Planet. You have had an awesome season, winning Player of the Month once and scoring 17 goals this season. When you look back at the season, what key lessons do you pick from it?
It's been great, you know. My first season in Premier League, scoring 17 goals is not easy, you know. Even though the season did not end the way I wanted it, you know, because in the first half of the season, I scored a lot of goals, you know, and people were expecting more from me, you know. But the second half of the season was not like the first half of the season. But I still thank God because from my first season in Premier League, scoring 17 goals in our competition and my team still remain in Premier League. I think for me, it's a great achievement and I'm grateful to God for that. And I want to keep building from that and look forward to the next season.
Right, so tell me, your current coach is leaving at the end of this season and he definitely had an impact on your career, didn't he?
Yeah, I'm grateful to Kike Sanchez-Flores because it's a coach that gave me the opportunity to play every game this season. I played like 37 games this season in the Premier League and because he believed in me and he trusts me. So it's sad that he's leaving, you know, because, you know, in life, you can't have 10 coach all your life or work in the same place in 20 years. So I think the owner of the club decide to change the idea and they want to bring somebody else. So I just wish him all the best wherever he goes to. I wish him because he's a nice man and he's a very calm guy. So and he's a very good coach.
Sure, there are suggestions. You may be exiting the EPO at the start of the new season. Is that the case?
I don't think I'll be leaving the Premier League because I think it suits me and I'm happy here. But you never can say, you know, football, we don't, in last minute, some things can happen and you change teams. So, but for now, I think I want to remain in Premier League.
So not even when Arsenal come calling?
Well, I have a 4 years contract with Watford. I'm happy here. The fans love me. I love the fans. I'm doing well here. I'm playing week in, week out. So I don't want to talk about Arsenal. I don't want to talk about another team for now. I just want to face my team, Watford. Then we'll see. But in future, you never can say, like I said. So I'm just happy here. But whenever, whatever happens in future, then everybody will know.
Thanks for speaking to us, Jude Ighalo. To other news, at the helm of FIFA's Secretary General office is a stranger to the football world, but the Senegalese Fatma Samoura may end up being that stranger FIFA needed all this while. Here are some facts about her. Moving on to other stories, as Cameroon prepares to host the Women's Nations Cup, there are concerns about the readiness of its infrastructure as a portion of one of the stadiums earmarked for the tournament collapsed last week. We speak to a sports journalist and a member of the backroom staff of the Cameroonians Women's National Football Team, Leocadia Bongben. And thanks for your time, Leocadia. Following the recent collapse of a part of the Yaoundé Stadium, is Cameroon ready in terms of infrastructure-wise for the tournament in November?
Yes, I would say Cameroon is ready and would be ready. When you look at the field, the grass has been planted. The seats are already, some of them are already there. I visited the place with the Prime Minister and I can tell you Cameroon is going to be ready. Yeah, it doesn't send a good signal because somebody died. They are walking around the clock and I can tell you Limbe is ready. They are working on the access to the stadium, and Yaoundé, the bulk of the work remaining is still just where there's the presidential tribune, the VIP tribune, and they want to do another media, a press room that will be maybe better than what we have there now.
Right, thanks for speaking to us, Leocadia. Still staying on the continent, though, we have some midweek fixtures of the CAF Confederations Cup for you. But before that, the president of the Confederation of African Football, Issa Hayatou, has announced a new format for the Confederation Cup and CAF Champions League, with the two leagues having 16 clubs of four teams each, with effect from 2017. A charismatic figure who went on to achieve global fame and prominence, Zambia's Kalusha Boila is our legend for this week. So it's a wrap. Thanks for staying with us here on Football Planet. It remains your hottest sport for everything football. You can follow us on Twitter at Africanews and visit our website, www.africanews.com. So my name is Juliet Bowe, and I did this with the support of the team here at Africanews. See you same time next week. Stay on tight.